Once again, data from the now-defunct Kepler spacecraft has yielded something very strange. Unprecedented strange in the same way that the star KIC 8462852, or Tabby's star, was back in 2016 when I started this channel. Now, we have another star, and it's even stranger than Tabby's star. In a paper by Saul Rappaport and colleagues linked below, they detail a new star studied for 87 days during the K2 Kepler mission. The Kepler spacecraft was a photometer. It measured light coming from stars confined in a small patch of sky long term. This allowed scientists to watch if dips in the light occurred when objects passed between Kepler and the parent stars, such as exoplanets, but also exocomets or dust clouds or whatever might pass by. Through this method, Kepler found over 2,000 exoplanets. But it also found anomalies that were not readily explainable, such as Tabby's star, which today, while we know is caused by dust, just why that dust behaves as it does is still a mystery. But HD 139139 is even stranger than that. With Tabby's star, the most likely explanation had always been dust, but it was sufficiently strange that for a time, alien megastructures were a long-shot possibility. It's the same with HD 139139, but in this case, it's harder to envision what it might be. When exoplanets transit their star in the Kepler data, they do it like clockwork. As they orbit their star, they come back around and block the light periodically, just like you would see Earth pass by every 365 days if you were sitting in space looking at the sun from a stationary vantage point. This gives scientists the orbital period for exoplanets, and the depth of the dip reveals the exoplanet's size. This is all very reliable for a normal star system, though some small anomalies can occur when planets tug on each other under certain circumstances, but not HD 139139. HD 139139's light curve shows numerous dips, and all of these dips look just like normal planets in transit. The problem is, they aren't anything close to periodic. In fact, the dips appear completely random. It gets weirder. Whatever objects are passing in front of this star, with the exception of one, they're all about the same size. The exception is roughly twice the size of the rest, all totaling about 28 dips over 87 days. There are actually two stars in the data for HD 139139, and they are probably linked as a binary star system. But one star, the main one in the system, looks eerily familiar. It's a type G star, similar to our Sun, though younger at about 1.5 billion years old. There are a number of potential explanations on the table for what's happening with this star. First is that it simply has a lot of planets. But this is problematic. Given that they all passed by within 87 days, these planets likely could not be on stable orbits being so close together. Even assuming that some of them are orbiting the second star, it still comes out a complete unlikely mess, so this explanation seems ruled out even though the dips really do look like planets. Another option, though again not a good one, is that the system is full of asteroids that are evaporating. This has been seen before in the Kepler data, and it does cause strange patterns of dips, but not ones that are almost all the same size. Asteroids emitting dust and gas should be all over the place in variability, and present all sorts of sizes. Yet another is that it represents a disintegrating planet. This would require a planet to be torn apart somehow, and the dust from that event having been blown out of the system by the star. Trouble is, there should still be evidence of periodicity here, and that's not seen. Another would be the dynamics of planets around a binary star system producing unusual transits, but no stable configuration for this has been modeled to explain HD 139139's light curve. There are some other options that are not well understood by science that might be responsible. Young stars can have circumstellar disks of material around them. That means that dust clumps within these disks can produce some odd light curves. But with this, you would see infrared emissions as the dust would be warmed by the star. This hasn't been seen, and these disks are typically found around young stars. HD 139139 isn't young, and again, the light curve reveals that these objects really do look like planets, as opposed to messy dust. Another option are star spots of a type we've never seen before. This is possible as we don't have a good handle on just what stars can do in this regard. We know what the Sun does, and we can see star spots in the Kepler light curves, but maybe there is a new type of short-term star spot that doesn't occur with our Sun, even though it's in the same class as HD 139139. The problem is, with our Sun, spots tend to last a while, and in Kepler they can be seen multiple times passing by as the star rotates. In this case, the spots on HD 139139 would have to be very short-lived, on the order of hours. That doesn't seem a good fit, but it's probably the best natural explanation advanced so far. The last option, and by far the least likely, is that we may be seeing something entirely different. While it's overwhelmingly likely that the behavior of HD 139-139 is of natural astrophysical origin, there remains the possibility that it may be of alien origin, similar to the possibilities with KIC 8462852 early on. The idea there was that gigantic alien megastructures might be responsible for blocking the light in the star's light curve. In the case of HD 139-139, that also applies. I'm a science fiction author, so I can speculate a little further than the scientists can. And while HD 139-139 really looks like planets doing strange things, it's actually a better fit for the idea of alien megastructures than Tabby Star was. As with Tabby Star initially, an idea was brought up regarding messaging from alien civilizations. In the early 2000s, astronomer Luke Arnold proposed that instead of sending out energy-expensive radio signals, it might be easier to announce your presence visually to others in the galaxy through transiting objects, linked to Arnold's paper below. Arnold envisioned unnatural shapes, such as triangles or even louvers, blocking the light to scream that the objects transiting the star were artificial. This would in turn be visible long distance to any alien astronomers that have spacecraft like Kepler. This kind of thinking might apply for creating what appears to be an impossible star system. If the planets in the system, or for that matter megastructures, or even something simple like giant star shades, behaved in a manner not possible in nature without involving technology, then that would be a dead ringer for an alien civilization announcing its presence. But, as usual, there are problems. Given that HD 139-139 is only 1.5 billion years old, that doesn't seem like enough time for intelligent life to be present on any planets there. Earth's life at that time was microbial only, so it seems a stretch for there to be life there. But highly advanced alien civilizations likely could traverse the stars and maybe even use one as a signpost. Alien scientists might go for a very basic route for communication. Announce your presence to other alien astronomers simply by creating something that appears to be impossible in nature without technology. This may make more sense to them instead of trying to create a narrowband radio signal broadcasting at the hydrogen line, or sending out message containing universal mathematical information, such as pi. Perhaps the spacing between the dips means something. Maybe mathematical messages might be contained within patterns of these objects passing by. But that's all highly unlikely and speculative compared to some natural phenomenon that we just haven't seen an example of yet or thought about how it might be. The next step is to eliminate dust as an option and show that these are indeed opaque objects like planets. Then the objects need to be observed long-term and studied. What will be weird, and this is where we start to move into alien territory, is that if after years of observation and thinking, no strong explanation is found. It gets worse if we don't find any other examples of a system like this. Unique systems raise eyebrows. Only time will tell, and watch this channel for future updates on HD 139-139. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently experiencing déjà vu. The first video I did on this channel was an exposé very much like this one on KIC 8462852. Now we have another one. It all makes me very misty, though you're probably saying to yourself, JMG, 2016 called and wants its mystery back. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.